Hi guys, it's Nitron99 again. I'll be doing a different thing. It'll be a commentary on the new Lego pictures that have been slowly trickling out in the last couple days. Start off with Ninjago, of course, and this fantastic golden ninja because everyone likes Ninjago the most, and of course people want to see this first. But we'll also be having the Lego city. It's just fantastic, always. Hobbit, which is really cool because I mean, finally get to see all the sets, and I haven't read the book in a while, but I pretty much know what's going on, and I also can see how the movie is going to progress. And it's going to be three movies, I believe, or no, two movies. I can't remember. Three movie Hobbit movies or two. Anyway, but yeah, we'll see what the first movie is going to be about. And besides Lego City and Hobbit, there's also Batman. We get to see a couple of Batman sets, and finally Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which was just released. And I'm glad I waited to make this video. I originally planned on doing it 2 days, 2.5 days ago, but I couldn't because I just didn't have time to sit down and put this together because I have to talk and there's people walking by and I have to put it all together. It takes a little longer than just throwing some pictures down. So, hope you enjoyed nonetheless. We start off with this golden ninja, which I'm presuming is Lloyd because of the green accents on his robe. The green, I can't say the green is fantastic. I mean, for me, it's just, I like the ninja a lot, but the green just doesn't do it. I think maybe something else brighter, but I think it's Lloyd. Lloyd is that special kid, you know, he's just been everything. So yeah, next we'll see golden dragons and also golden robots and other Ninjago sets. So as you can see, this is set one of the sets that the golden ninja comes in. It's a golden dragon. And I actually like the golden dragon a lot, even though it has green on it. I think it works. And I guess what else you could do is black, but there's already some black in there, so it looks pretty good. So there's golden ninja. He also has the golden sword, fire, it seems. And of course, he shoots balls out of his mouth, which is a common play feature for dragons. Everyone knows dragons shoot balls. And this is one of the enemies, which looks pretty good, I think. It's one of Garmadon's drones, like his Garmadon's back, so it's the red. It looks pretty cool. It's like a samurai, dark samurai thing. But you know, it's the usual kind of dinky thing to add to the dragons. And apparently there's two bad guys to get, so that's three minifigures. I'm guessing this set will probably be around 60 or 70, maybe $80. Who knows, maybe 90 because all the gold pieces, but yeah. Next we have the smallest set in the Ninjago line, and it's actually one of the best in my opinion, because look at that mech. Isn't that cool looking? I mean, it is very well built from what I can see here from a picture, and it just looks fantastic. The sword on the left hand is a little small though. Next comes in a set is a little one of the goons. He's kind of goofy looking, but you know, I won't complain. It looks has some interesting parts. Finally, this is the redone of the ninjas. Their new outfit. It's like a kimono. Personally, I think the aesthetics of this outfit just looks really good because it kind of shows that they're accomplished ninjas now. You know, it's season four or whatever. And it sounds like they're masters of their domain. And yeah, it's just, I like it a lot. Especially the red and black. I like red and black. Now we have the second set. It's around $20 or $30, imagine. It is the weirdest Ninjago set I've ever seen. One of the weirdest Lego sets I've ever seen. It's weirder than the Time Twisters. And of course belongs to Jay. I mean, what is that thing? What is it? At least the figures are cool, which I don't have any pictures of that, so unfortunately, but I have to ask, what is that thing? It's supposed to be some kind of tread, I don't know, but it's weird. Okay, after that weird thing, which probably very few people will buy, except for the Jay figure, which I don't think is anything else. This is cool. This is Cole's vehicle. It's gold, brown, and black, and looks really good. As you know, has a giant drill in the front. Of course, he's Earth Ninja. One of the figures has these. I guess these new swords are the new things to get. Like, you have to collect them, just like every other thing. So instead of the staffs, it's the swords. And here's a closer look at the figures. I think Cole looks really good. Once again, he's accomplished. You know, the sensei. There's a sword, which is okay. I mean, can't really say much about that. The bad guy, pretty basic, but it's the bad guys. But Cole was black, gray, and silver. Looks nice. Okay, next we have one of the largest sets. It's Garmadon's bug tank thing. That's pretty weird, but I think on the front of the bug thing, yeah, it looks like a face. It looks kind of like Garmadon's face. There's Garmadon. He's that tall red guy, a bad guy, and also Zane. He's only in this set, I think. Might be in the big temple set. Not sure. Here's a closer look at that. Garmadon is prominently displayed at the top, like an overlord, and it has also has a flick one of those giant missiles in the mouth, which looks actually is kind of cool. That'd be good. Those are good to shoot. Here's Zane. You can't really see his torso, but and his golden phallic saws coming. It's just creepy, in my opinion. Not sure what it is. Here are the figures, though. And wow, Zane. I really like Zane a lot. Man, it's almost one of my favorite ones. The goon, meh. Once again. But Garmadon, on the other hand, look at that. I mean, his two torsos. His face probably looks fantastic. It looks sick. And his samurai helmet looks great. He just looks sweet. And finally, this is the box art for it. I'll also show the other box arts, which I didn't show earlier, and I won't say much on them because nothing to say. However, now we have something to say. This is the largest set. Once again, you get the Golden Ninja. You get like Black Garmadon and the Golden Ninja Samurai unit. I can't see any of the other figures though, except a Goon and also Sensei Wu. But yeah, it's a flagship of the line. Final Battle, it says. And also, if you didn't notice about the boxes, it has up in the right-hand corner a very nice picture of the Golden Ninja. I think it's a lot better than the Green Ninja, which I was never fond of. But yeah, the Golden Ninja looks pretty sweet. Now we move on to Batman, which apparently is not showing the whole on the whole screen, which is just great. Picture's too large, but we've seen the figures before. I put them on Facebook. I did something with them, but this is the Arkham Asylum exclusive set. It's gonna be expensive, but it's one of those direct-to-consumer sets, and it looks really good. It's pretty gothic in its design, architecture-wise. It's pretty similar to the old one, and the ambulance has a little cart, you know, hold down place for the inmates like Joker, and you put the figure in there and pop them in. It says Harley Quinn, and it has Poison Ivy once again, Scarecrow and Joker and Batman and all the usual suspects. So it's a nice set, expensive though. This is one of the sets I was just shown at Comic-Con yesterday, and it is a Dark Knight Rises set. And I have to say, we knew it was coming because we saw the figures, but I have to say it's pretty nice for the most part. I mean, it's gonna be cheap. It's gonna be around $40, which is great for people who can't spend a lot and don't want to spend a lot on Lego because it's expensive. It's really expensive. But this, I mean, look at the tumbler. The tumbler is a little small, you could say. But I think, in my opinion, it works. It's more to scale with minifigures, kind of. It could be a little larger on the width, but for the most part, I think it's great. And it's also this. Tan color. Unfortunately, that means we might not be able to get a black one, but that also means you can make a black one because it's just take follow the instructions to use black colors. The bat, on the other hand, is a little different. I don't really like it. It looks kind of like a TIE fighter from the old days. Because Lego seems to think that when you make a black ship, they have to have blue in it for some reason, just like the TIE fighters, and there's no blue on it, and especially in the movie, there's no blue on this bat. So I don't get the reasoning why you have to put blue. It's disappointing, to say the least, so you have to change that, which I don't usually do, but I'll buy the set for sure. And the figures, if you haven't seen them, they're floating around pictures somewhere out there. I don't have any on my hard drive anymore. But the Bane looks amazing. Batman, Dark Knight Rises Batman looks great, and Commissioner Gordon is fantastic as well. Here we have a Spider-Man set, and sorry for the cropped image. I had to recrop it twice just to show everything. So this is the first one. You can see the top has Jonah Jameson's picture up there in the office, DBC. And here are the minifigures. Overall, the set doesn't wow me. It's just unspectacular set-wise. But the figures, on the other hand, once again, knock me down and take my money. It's because the figures are fantastic. I mean, you get Doctor Doom, Beetle, who I don't even know who that is, Nova, who I only know because I watched the TV show like two times, and Spider-Man and Jonah Jameson, which I, of course, I know because everyone knows who those are. But Doctor Doom, everyone knows who that is as well. So the figures, fantastic. The set, unspectacular, in my opinion. Some people like it. I actually kind of good for just a generic office building for Lego City, if you need that. But other than that, I guess it's worth picking up for the figures, of course. And also, you could always bricklink them in the future. They probably would be worth a lot of money. So that is it for the superhero sets. Now we move on to something else. We are moving on to Lego City once again. Lego City has struck back. And this is actually based on the Lego City video game, which is commonly referred to by me as Grand Theft Auto Lego City. And it has a main protagonist for once. It's Jack something. I think every protagonist in Lego is named Jack eventually. And once again, the small set of the line is a buggy, a police buggy. We haven't seen this before, of course. It's a brand new concept. And it comes with this little happy dude with handcuffs and this criminal who looks really mean and he has a crowbar. So, of course, we know who's going to win this. The policemen, of course, because they're good and they have justice on the side and the flashlight of justice. So now we shall see the figures, or I should say figure, because I'm not putting all these pictures in at once. And this is the only figure we get to see of this set. It is the bad guy, and of course he has a new face, just like the policeman. The torso is new. He has his wheelbarrow, which I don't have a wheelbarrow, unfortunately, and a crowbar, which isn't new. Jewels, and he looks pretty good. I like just generic figures like this you can use for army and stuff, customizing. So now we have another police set to see. Here we have a very cool set, in my opinion. I think all the vehicles except the motorcycle, which we've seen countless times, is very cool. This is a Lamborghini in Lego, apparently. Well, it looks like a Lamborghini. And the truck even looks pretty sick. I mean, that also comes with Jack exclusive minifigures, says in the top. I don't see what else it says. But it's the Jack dude. Maybe he's not named Jack. Maybe his name is Wilson. And of course, the criminal is a different criminal. And of course, Lego has promoted Lamborghini violence by having a Lamborghini drive over the spike strips so it ruins the car, so it crashes and burns, and it's a Lamborghini Lego. Don't do that. And here is a closer look. A motorcycle cop, Lamborghini, two criminal, and the good guy Jack. The truck looks neat. It's just overall very basic stuff you have included, but I like the design of all these vehicles. Might actually be a set I get, hopefully. Of course, there's so many other things to buy as well. But this, I can see, looks cool. Now we have the flagship of the police line. There might be other sets, but I didn't see any. And it's the museum robbery. It has a helicopter, a bad guy van, which is looks ni nice. Lego's really stepping up their game in vehicles recently for Lego City. The Lego City SWAT truck, police truck thing, and of course the museum, which is simple but effective. It's small, but it looks well built. Also the interior. You can't see the interior, unfortunately, but the back, I guess that open back, but we'll see. Here's a closer look at the police van. It has a couple of happy figures, including the one guy in the front left. He is a clone, of course. He has a clone army in Lego City. Genetic experiments going on. There's that happy dude again. He's very happy. And there's another happy dude behind him, a little child, a little boy. Looks like little Jimmy's older brother. And next we have the criminals. And look at that guy in the left. Look at that face. That face is awesome. He's grinning. He's mischievous. His slicked back hair. His eye covering. And then there's the other guy behind him who's just kind of there. And then there's, you can see, a painting sticker, a bunch of stickers. That's pretty much all we can see. Even the red laser things for the security. Here's this whole set. And a little closer, you get apparently six minifigures. And well, it looks pretty nice to me. I like this set. The van, I wish I could have seen a little closer, but we'll have to wait until it comes out. Now, after all my enthusiasm is mustered because those police sets are cool, now they'll be sucked out of me because these firemen sets I've never really cared much about. They're taking out this abandoned building is on fire, so they have to, take the fire out. And there's also a random barrel that's on fire. And you got three firemen, and that's pretty much it. I never saw the play features of these sets, but apparently people like them. Kids, of course. And here is a fire boat, which kind of reminds me of a couple weeks ago, Japan firing their water cannons on merchant boats. It's a nice play feature you can reenact with this. Thank you, Lego. course, another set I won't be getting. It just doesn't seem very interesting, but reminds me, I don't have any firemen figures, actually. Funnily enough. And this one is the final one. I have to admit, the cargo helicopter looks pretty nice, but there seems to be a chemical a gas thing that's on fire. So, of course, the best way to tackle that is, of course, to swing in, fire hydrant blazing, and get blown up in the process, because that's what's going to happen. Okay, now that we're done with the idiocy of Lego Fire, we have a new line coming out. It's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and this is a new license theme, which I have mixed feelings about more license themes, but here they are. And unfortunately, I don't know much of anything about Ninja Turtles. I know that vehicle there, the big one, I believe that is the Ninja Turtles vehicle. It's probably on a new cartoon series, which I haven't watched. And you get two of the turtles, the orange masked dude and the blue masked dude. I don't know their names. I only know Donatello, Raffaello. I'm so sorry, my ignorant on the subject. You also get this big guy, which is nicely molded, and two other fellows, and a skateboard, and a little fan that doesn't look very well. But it does promise to be an interesting theme. We shall see how it goes. I know a lot of people will probably buy it anyway. But of course, I saw in the Facebook comments some people who are fans of Ninja Turtles. They weren't very enthusiastic about having it based on the new TV show. But of course, that's the only one you'd base it on. You're not going to base it on that Michael Bay movie or older TV shows which aren't aired anymore. But yeah, we shall see. We shall see. Now, in my opinion, we save the best for last, the Hobbit sets. This is the small set, Riddles for the Ring. Personally, I think it should be named after the chapter. I'm sorry. Riddles in the Dark, but what can you do? It has two new figures. Yes, that Sméagol Gollum is new. He has a different facial expression. You also get Bilbo, which is new, of course, because you don't have him. Next is the Moria, Escape from Mirkwood for Spiders. What am I talking about? Moria. Idiot me. And of course, don't think that these sets are chronologically in order. Smallest starts the beginning. No, this is about midway. It's near the end of the movie, I imagine. But you get some elves. Unfortunately, I don't remember who these elves are. I think that might be new characters introduced by Peter Jackson. A couple dwarves. Can't really see who they are. And the spiders look kind of dim, in my opinion. Their faces looks dim. Yeah, I can't complain. It's the Lord of the Rings Hobbit set. Next, we have Attack of the Wargs, which takes place after the Goblin King when they're escaping, and the wargs chase them and they have to hide up in a tree, all of them. And of course, you don't get all of the figures, but you do get quite a few, and the wargs look really nice. You can see kind of them there. They're kind of chopped up. The image is chopped up. But, yeah. Just looks pretty nice, in my opinion. The tree's well built. Of course, it's the main part of the set. But another set of beginning for sure. And here's a better picture, a closer picture. I still can't tell who the figures are except for the two goblins there. But the wargs you can see a little better. And overall, the vibrancy of the pick colors and stuff in this picture is very nice. You get three dwarves, not sure who they are. Now, finally, this is the barrel escape. It's probably the very end of the movie because they escape from the barrels, go down to Dale. And they see Smaug. That's the end. This next movie, of course, some spoilers, but no one's gonna remember that. And you haven't read the book. You should read the book if you haven't. I mean, it's a great book. You should read it. But there's two elves. Not sure who they are. There's a couple dwarves in the prison. Bilbo is rescuing them and uses ring, of course. And yeah, it's a nice set. It's a more expensive one. It's the second largest set to the final set, which is the flagship. This is the large set, which of course is cropped a little again, but this is another picture of it. The Goblin King battle, and they meet the Goblin King. I don't remember exactly what happens, how they get escape, but the Goblin King is huge. You can see it's right there. There's the giant albino giant thing in the middle. The goblins are, you can see from this, the goblins are actually the heads from the Harry Potter one, which is odd. I think it's not finalized, but because the goblins and the other Warg attack were, the Moria goblins or the Mordor goblins. But you also get Gandalf, you can see in the bottom, and probably a couple of dwarves. Frodo is probably, I mean, Bilbo is not in this set, I think, if it stays true to the book. Of course, actually, he might have actually been in this, and then he disappears. I can't remember. But of course, here's the better picture of the goblins. The purple guy. There's another dwarf that's reddish. Another dwarf with an orange hat. And Gandalf. Three goblins. The Goblin King. And you can see his throne back there. It's the whole set centers around the throne, which is nice. I like that. And that would, of course, be the flagship final set. It seems like the movie, the first movie, is going to be taking part mostly, most of the book. In a way, the last part, the second movie, will be include a lot of stuff that wasn't included in the book, which is, I like that stuff because I like to see more about the Necromancer and, of course, the Battle of the Five Armies, which wasn't even talked about in the book because Tolkien wasn't very good at writing about battles. So, yeah. Hope you enjoyed this video. For what I did, it's kind of long, of course, but you know, there's a lot of pictures and I have to talk about it. And there's also Hero Factory, which I don't know much about, so I think you, I should suggest going to Lego Lee 329. I think he probably did a video about it. If not, maybe he will. But he knows a lot more about Hero Factory than I do. And also, I didn't show the other Hobbit set, the one we saw before. It's the Hobbiton. Of course, that looks very good as well. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Probably do another one sometime when there's more pictures like Star Wars. Hopefully, there's Star Wars pictures coming out soon. And of course, see you guys later. Like, comment, subscribe, favorite. Bye.